I have the means, the skill, but something's missing.
We're delighted to have you on the team, Lieutenant.
It's Merkel at the station. Something about a giant bat.
No excuses! That vigilante bastard goes under, instantly, or it's your job.
This Batman is working his way up the crime ladder, from junkie to pusher to supplier.
You've eaten Gotham's wealth, its spirit. From this moment on, none of you are safe.
Frank Miller, he basically sort of changed the way comics were looked at and told.
He did it within the body of the series, didn't put a number one on it. The number one was really the title. Batman Year One was signifying that this is the first issue, a first story of something embedded within the ongoing series itself.
He brought almost like this brutal, realistic, noirish feel to it. And I think it definitely changed the face of how the audience interprets and reads comics.
It set the tone for Batman that probably exists to this day as the Dark Knight.
I said, you know, it's crazy to not be doing this. It's one of the most famous comics of all time. It's one of the best Batman comics of all time. It's been so influential in all media.
It's not as epic as a lot of the other movies that we've done, which are like, you know, save the world. This one's like very small scale, and it's very real.
There's very little science fiction in it. You know, there's, you know, even all of Batman's gadgets, you know, it's all very, very low tech.
With my belt gone, I'm down to a blowgun, 3 darts, and an unofficial invention of Wayne Electronics.
Every time you work with Bruce has such a clear vision of what he wants to do. And so I think as a director, a lot of times, you just sort of try to figure out, you know, how is he going to play this one?
I'm just such a huge fan of the comic that I wanted to do as faithful an adaptation as possible.
We really translated the comic almost word for word from the book to the screen.
You know, Batman Begins did do the origin story, and they did pull some material from Batman Year One, but it wasn't a straight adaptation. There was a lot of the stuff they left still on the table. Most important to me is that it's really more about Jim Gordon than it is about Bruce Wayne.
This is no place to raise a family. Maybe Gotham's all I deserve now.
What I was first attracted to in reading Batman Year One was that James Gordon actually is the star. That's the way I look at it, anyway. You know, Batman, Bruce Wayne, is just kind of an added colorful figure.
It's told from his point of view, from Gordon's point of view, and so we get to hear what he's thinking.
And so there's all this awesome material about, you know, Jim Gordon when he first arrives in Gotham City, and he starts how he deals with the corruption, and you know, just all of this great, you know, psychodrama stuff that's going on with him.
I hate the job. I hate the gun. But I keep practicing.
You know, in this piece he has an affair, and it's eating away at him.
I need to come clean with Barbara, beg for forgiveness. I can't stop thinking about her. Like I can't stop thinking about Batman. He's a criminal. I'm a cop. It's as simple as that.
Origin stories in general, they're appealing because it gets to sort of the core fiber of what drives that character.
He's a real vigilante. He's a tough, sort of tortured soul who is exacting revenge upon a criminal element that took something away from him.
Batman, in this comic particularly, you get to see kind of two origin stories. You get to see, you know, him as a child and what drives him to kind of work towards becoming this hero, but you also get to see him actually, you know, get the idea to become the Batman.
I know pain. Sometimes I share it with someone like you.
such an interesting dynamic between the two characters. Young Lieutenant Gordon, who's about to become a father for the first time, and Bruce Wayne, who is only just beginning to figure out how he's going to focus his energies towards something that makes him feel better about his life, because he's this crazy wealthy guy whose parents have been taken from him so young. And so for many years, he's boiled this fury inside him until he's found a way to actually use it.
12 years, and the ache is still fresh, like a raw, angry nerve.
The origin is so incredibly strong. It's so identifiable, so relatable. Any child with the loss of a parent is something that any person can feel that pain. And therefore, you know that it's not a pain that's going to go away, and becomes a strong motivation for who Batman is. So Batman as the character, as Bruce Wayne, it's very clear you don't want to mess with that origin. But the good part about it is that it's not, the book's not just about Batman. It's about Commissioner Gordon.
They were almost like the only two people in that city that were trying to do something, and they needed each other. And each other was almost the missing piece that would make the situation work.
That is the most interesting of stories that needs to be explored. The relationship between the cop and the vigilante.
It's as close an adaptation as we could make it. And that goes for the script and the visuals. We definitely tried to mimic David Mazzucchelli's style.
What Mazzucchelli brought to that story was that film noir sensibility that really just permeates all of Frank Miller's books.
We absolutely, followed even the color palette, because it's a really unique palette. I mean, especially at the time period when it first came out, it was like, wow, you'd never really seen a comic that looked like that. It was all these really muted, almost ugly colors.
It kind of lends itself to the mood of the comic being that Gotham is a very kind of down and out sort of place. It's not a place you want to be.
We sort of figured out a technique in Photoshop where we can actually drop the color out and stuff like that, and actually use the actual comic book panel as one of the frames.
Mazzucchelli's style is, it's very simple. He has simple, strong lines. We weren't able to translate it 100% in that his line quality has a lot of, I guess, variation in the thickness of the lines. And with animation, we have to kind of simplify it and keep the lines a certain thickness. So it's a cleaner line in the style that we used, but we definitely tried to keep the look of the characters very, very close to the same.
Well, this is the first time we meet Selina Kyle in the DC Comics for Batman Year One, and she starts out as a prostitute.
This story turned out to be so dark and so going down an avenue I never anticipated that I thought, this is what it should be. It should be twists and turns and darkness and light and mistakes and things, so that it's not a kid's story.
Dealing in the very real world kind of viewpoint that it has, it's very gritty in terms of, Gotham City's an ugly place, and there's prostitution, and there's drugs, and there's all this stuff in it.
I hear Falcone's got a fortune in old stuff. Maybe I'll give the Roman a little scratch before I steal it. On the face. I won't think it's Batman if I give him a scratch. I found the attitude for this character deep down in the Eliza Dushku archive of bad girls. Pretty much. They're in there somehow, somewhere, for some reason. And I tap into them when I need them. And I put on my leather pants, and that always kind of helps.
There's a character in this piece called Essen, and it's a female police officer that ultimately Gordon has an affair with.
Mind if I ask you a personal question? I know why I'm here, but what are you doing here?
She kind of gives Lieutenant Gordon really a shoulder to kind of like lean on, and like a common ground when his wife is pregnant.
Because we meet a lot of really nasty, both police officers and gang bosses in this piece, we wanted to fill it with what I call actors who have voices with character, as opposed to actors who do character voices.
Hey, Let's not kid ourselves, okay? Batman is costing us all money. It's fun playing gangsters. Where else can you say, get up against the wall, I'm gonna blow your head away? You know, I mean, I really love playing gangsters.
It's a grittier story that feels like it's from a certain time, and I think that's one of the things that we really try to capture.
You couldn't be any more literal with it. I mean, it's dead on.